had never heard of autism, and it was kind of shocking when we heard that this one doctor said it was childhood schizophrenia.
We're a young couple. We didn't know how to handle it. Every time we went out, it was stressful. It was constant.
To get that diagnosis was devastating, especially because we had two children with autism. And then we're like, well, what are we going to do now? And what's the answer to this?
40 years ago, if you had a child with autism, the only option available was to live in an institution. They would be in chemical restraint, and they would be in physical restraint. That's how bleak an outcome.
For a long time, people thought that the child's problems were due to the parents not bringing them up properly. And so mothers and fathers looked at each other's grandparents. Here was a child who was completely different than anything that was expected of him. And somebody, somewhere, had to be at fault.
Parents are faced with the reality that my child is not in school anymore. Where will he or she live? Where will he or she work? What happens when I'm too old to care for my child?
Everywhere we turned, we found that we were being treated and not the child. This was disturbing because the child was the one who needed treatment. We began to look for solutions.
You can look forever for the cure, and you can waste all your money and waste your child's life. You want to get on with it. You want to change his behaviors. Get him or her to fulfill their potential.
Applied behavior analysis is the science of human behavior. We know better how to shape behavior that allows people to be independent.
We saw children who were attending, who had eye contact.
They were talking, using language, starting to acquire skills.
And we're like, oh my God, how do we get them in there? This is the place.
And it was a real breakthrough.
This was revolutionary thinking.